Let's talk about computer properties today. I have the same project that we've been working on. I just cleared out all the code that we had written before. So let's talk about what the problem is, and then we'll talk about computer properties and how they fix what we're going to talk about. Imagine that we had a price for a particular product, and then we had a tax, and then we needed the total, right? Which is basically just the addition of our product price plus the tax on that product. So why don't we start with a very simple example, and we're simply going to add a div here, and it's just going to have some sort of price. I will just say 123, right? And this will be our price. So let's label that. And then we're going to have a tax, which is going to be some sort of amount. Also, we'll leave it at 123. We're not sure what it is yet. And then we're going to have a total, which is also going to have an amount. So why don't we set this up? Let's go ahead and add our data property. And so let's just say we have our price, which we'll set at maybe 100. And that's it. Everything else kind of gets just calculated off of the price. Let's just set price. That way we can see that in the browser. All right, let's go back here, hit refresh. And sure enough, we get our price is 100. Okay, so then we have the tax. Let's just assume for some reason the tax is going to be 10%. So we can say something like price times 0.1. That'll give us 10% of the price. Let's go back here. And sure enough, that's 10. So 100 plus 10, obviously this right here should be 110. So in this column here, we would have to do something like price plus the price times 0.1 equals to that. And if we hit refresh, there we go. So yes, at this point, it is working, right? If we changed our price, let's actually go ahead and change this value and make it a V model. That way we can actually change it. How about that? Let's say input, and it's gonna be a text, and we'll just say V model, you're gonna belong to our price. And then let's get rid of this. We don't need that. All right, so now it's dynamic. We could say 200, we can say 300. We do see a little thing here where we're actually getting this plus this, but only concatenated because we are not actually parsing int. We do need to do that if we want this to show up properly, because from here, this is actually being set as a string. So let's go ahead and then parse int on this. All right, so now that we have that, now we do need to parse this price as well. So let's go ahead and parse int on the actual price as well. And I believe that'll work. Let's see, 300, there we go. All right, so yes, it is working. We are calculating our tax and our total properly. But this here, well, it doesn't really mean anything. When I come back to this, I don't know what this does because there's no real name for it. So this is where a computer property really shines in. And so here's what we could do. So let's add a new section here, and it will be called computed. So computed will actually be treated almost like a data variable. Let me show you how it works. We'll call our variable tax, and then we'll say, all right, well, this will be a function. And of course, it needs to return the same value that we have before. So how do we grab this price? Well, we could simply say this.price that will grab this price right here. And then we're gonna times 0.1. Okay, so then inside of here, I will replace all of this just with tax. So this tax here is calling this computer property right here. And after computer property, it looks like I missed semicolon. Let me go. So computer semicolon. And so it is this tax right here. Let's go check it out in the browser. Refresh. And there we go. So we have our tax here. But now check this out. When I say 200, yep, it still works. So that's pretty cool because now I have this new invisible data variable, which is called tax. And it is a computer property, which means that it automatically gets updated. All right, so now let's do the same thing for total. So I will actually grab this here. I will copy that. And let's add a new computed property for total. So we'll say total function. That's going to return. For now, I will bring this in, but I do need to modify it. So this.price. And we still need to parse int because this here actually gets set as a string. So we need to make sure that JavaScript treats it as an integer. And so instead of this section here though, what I can actually call is this.tax. And this is actually going to fix one small problem for us, and I'll show you what that is in just a second. So instead of all of this, I will replace that with just total. So this total will come from this computed property right here. All right, let's give it a go, see if it works. Go back here, hit refresh, and sure enough, now if we put 300, our total is still working. But now the nice thing with this is that we have a single source of truth for the taxable amount. So if tomorrow we needed to change this amount to 2, meaning 20% is tax, we go back here, we hit refresh, and there we are. We got 20, and our total is perfect. So how cool is that? So our tax is its own individual computed data property, and then we have a computed total data property that we are actually computed on the fly. So as this price changes, these computed properties change. Now there are a lot of uses for computed properties. I would like to show you another one, and it would be the following. What if we wanted to display, for example, a dollar sign in front of this tax? Well, what I could actually do in that case is maybe let's make a new one for tax formatted. And then let's add it maybe underneath here. And we'll say tax formatted is going to be function. And this is simply going to return a dollar sign plus this.tax. And then we do need a comma down here. All right, let's go back. There we go. So now we have a nice computed property, and it is nicely formatted. We could do the same exact thing for total. So let's change this to total formatted. And again, I am just showing you some different uses for this so you can get some ideas on how you can actually use computed properties. So total formatted, that is also going to be equal to a function, and that is simply going to return a dollar sign plus this dot total. All right, hit refresh. And sure enough, we are nicely formatting our figures and everything works as expected. So that's computed properties. So go ahead and play around with some computed properties in your project. And when you're ready, let's move on to the next episode.